Campaigners trying to stop the high-speed rail link from going ahead have lost their legal battle. A judge rejected 9 out of 10 of the grounds brought by councils across the country, including Camden. The council leader there says 500 families could lose their homes, but today's judgment could pave the way for a small victory, as Paul Brand reports.
The look of life in Camden is about to change. High-speed rail comes with costs, and this community are among those who'll pay. At court, they tried to protest this morning, but a judge ruled the project will go ahead, despite the concerns of Camden and other councils.
Obviously, we're disappointed. 500 families will be forced from their homes because they'll be bulldozed. A school will have to be replaced, rebuilt and moved. We'll lose an open space in a graveyard. And the government has no plan in place to help us deal with those impacts locally.
And HS2 will hit Camden more than most. The line will run from a new station at Euston, starting underground before emerging close to Chalk Farm. Then it runs southwest towards Queen's Park before moving out of London to head north. The idea is to connect communities, but in Drummond Street, they'll be cut off. The Bangladeshi businesses that thrive here say the project blocks their road and any passing trade. But today the judge said that isn't unfair.
It took years to build this community, the cohesion and everything. Everybody worked hard on it, local council, local people, our people, and we're a set community now, and to discard that, I find it quite disgraceful.
Away from the anger of those working in Camden, there was a slight victory today for those living here. When HS2 is built, all of these flats, along with the whole of that block there and dozens more, will be torn down. Today, a judge told the government it will have to look again at how residents here are compensated. He said homeowners hadn't been properly consulted. In Camden, they think they'll now be offered more money, enough to make HS2 unaffordable.
We estimate that compensation would cost about £1 billion. And there's a very clear view from the community. If the government cannot afford fair compensation, then it cannot afford to go ahead with HS2.
But the government doesn't seem worried by the court's decision.
We won't be appealing against it. What we will do is we will redo the consultations, taking into account all the points that the judge made in his judgment, and we are determined to do that as quickly as possible.
So quickly, ministers don't expect any delays. However much it costs, however much people are paid, HS2 remains on time and en route to Camden.
So what are residents hoping for in terms of compensation then?
Well, the government has already offered lots of different types of compensation, Charlene, and what people want depends on how close they are to the track, how far along the route they are. But one thing that hasn't been offered so far is something called a property bond, and that's something that people in Camden particularly want, for example. Essentially, the worry with HS2 is that it will drag down property prices. Who wants to live next to a train track? What the property bond does is it promises people that the government will buy your home whenever you want, 5 years, 10 years' time, at the value that it is now before HS2 happens. In practice, though, that is extremely expensive. You don't get anything in Camden for less than £250,000 these days. I think what the government would rather do is just redo the consultation process, tick a few technical boxes as were outlined in court today, but they will have to consider whether that would be enough to satisfy a judge if this comes back to the High Court again.